building in the state where they saw it.
But I think that we are barking up the wrong tree, as it were, when we talk about what is right conservation, wrong conservation, because we are comparing the benchmarks of rightness with what is being done in the West, for example. You know, what is minimal intervention? But here, we are talking about a completely different city, a completely different culture, where whatever we are dealing with is part of living heritage. So we cannot museumize it or fossilize it in any way, because that will be an insult to the living crafts. So we have to actually formulate our own benchmark of what is right or wrong. And I think whenever we talk about interventions, the key thing is to respect the craft skills, the indigenous craft skills that surround us, whether we are using it to utmost sensitivity, whether we are giving enough freedom to the designer, the craftsman to innovate, because most crucially, that is what the spirit of Jaipur is. You know, it never did in its history stop inventing or reinventing itself. With every ruler, with every change of political regime, it reinvented its identity. And in a beautiful way, in the sense that, you know, keeping the old and the new and trying to, you know, create a kind of balance. And it's always it's an ongoing challenge. It never stops. But of course, there will always be criticism of whether we're doing the right thing or wrong thing. But as long as we respect the context of this monument and not compare the conservation with a monument, say, in, you know, Brighton or in London, or then I think we are actually creating history in a way.
But that's not the point. I mean, you suggest there's a grey line.